Good evening, brethren.
Good evening.
As I reflect through 2014, some verses came to mind in Scripture that kind of summed up the big thing that the Lord worked in my life for 2014. Genesis 18:14 says, "Is anything too hard for the Lord? At the time appointed, I will return unto thee according to the time of life, and Sarah shall have a son." Matthew 19:26 says, "Jesus looked at them and said, with man this is impossible, but with God all things are possible." Luke 1:37a says, "For with God nothing shall be impossible." Romans 4:21, "And being fully persuaded that what he had promised he was also able to perform." Amen. See, he's the horn. He's the strength. He's the strength of the unicorn. "I know that thou canst do all things." That's what Job said. Jeremiah 32:17. "Ah, Lord God, behold, thou hast made the heaven and the earth by thy great power and outstretched arm, and there is nothing too hard for thee." 2014 for me started out after a rebirth in October of 2013, where I had fully dedicated myself again to serving the Lord, and I had forsaken everything that I'd left behind. I left behind my tattooing business, and I left behind a lot of stuff. And I just had this renewed vigor. I just finished reading through the entire Bible, and I had a 40-day reading plan, and I had a nice. It allowed me to get this nice bird's eye view of the Scripture. And since then, in 2014, I haven't even made it through the entire Bible, because we can't even get through an entire book in a year here. It's gone from macroscopic to microscopic, but the benefit it's not, you understand what I mean. There's this nature of the Scriptures where you can just fall in, so to speak. You get in on one verse and you just fall in, and it's a good thing to fall in. I want to fall in deeper, so. Anyway, I start out in January. It had been three months, and I don't bring this up too often, but I'm going to bring it up because to me this is important. This was important for me. It was one of those things that was a confirmation to me that the Lord was working. I had attempted to quit smoking, but I just couldn't do it. I couldn't do it through any other means. It was impossible for me. Now, I know that there's people that are heathen, that they quit smoking every day, or they quit drinking coffee every day, or they quit doing this every day. But for me, I know that I could not do it on my own power. But it was a confirmation that he's still keeping me. He's keeping me from these things that I couldn't keep myself from. So I had this desire to want to serve God and to want to meet people that were serious about the truth. Now, I remember New Year's Eve last year. We were going around all these different churches, and we had went to this New Year's Eve. It was like this New Year's Eve get together, but it was like a family game night. Like, no one was talking about, and I remember being grieved that here I am with a group of people that have gotten together in the name of the Lord, and It wasn't. I'm not trying to say that there were some good things that came out of me going to some of these assemblies. We had meals cooked for us when we had moved and stuff. But I'm just saying that there wasn't a caliber of. I had this longing to want to connect with people that desired the same thing that I desired, was to see Jesus in heaven, and I have this hope, and everybody was just kind of like down here, and I was kind of up here, and I'm really thankful that I'm in this, not even a year later. Is anything too hard for God? Is anything too hard? So my job was demanding. This is back in March. I was working a lot, and I was talking more than I was working. And this is one thing that I want to give thanks for, is that over this past year, the Lord has shown me that being a good testimony at work isn't just about standing up for God and talking. It's about working. You're there to work. You've sold your time, like Brother Given has said, you sold your time to your employer, and so doing anything outside of that on company time, it's really, it's stealing. Well, you can tell somebody that all you want, but they've got to be able to see it. They've got to be able to see it for yourself. So, but anyway, it actually caused problems for me, because my boss, instead of being somebody that would recognize me as a hard worker, he kind of looked at me like I was a troublemaker, and he had organized stuff to where I couldn't attend the renewal. So I was like, well, how am I going to attend this renewal and stuff? Well, it had come up that everything, all of my situation had come up to where this is what the appearance that it had. It had this appearance that if I stayed, I was finally caught up on all my bills and I could start putting money aside. Do you see? I could start putting money aside. But I knew that I'm spiritually hungry. I'm starving here. And I know where I can go. I know where I can go. I might not have the means to go there, but I know where I can go to get fed right now. So I was faced with this decision. You can stay here and you can work and you can, you know, build up money, and you can die, or you can forsake this too, and God will make a way. You just ask him. He says, that's what he said, didn't he? This is what he said. He said, you just ask him, not nothing doubting. See, if my son asks for a piece of bread, am I going to give him a snake? It was the same thing. So I just prayed. I remember I prayed, Lord, just open a way and I'll go. I don't care what I got to leave. We had a flourishing garden, man. We had plants that were this tall, like the whole, that's the size of this room. Big old plants, best garden we ever had. Gone, thrown on. But see, we laid it up. We laid it up. God didn't forget what we left, and we're not looking back. I don't want to be offensive to the places where we were going, because we did get some good stuff out of some of the places we were going, but realistically, they really weren't doing their job. They really weren't. I was starving. But anyway, so God opened up the door. We came, and it's amazing that I have this opportunity to speak, like Brother Paul said, edify the brethren, and to have fellowship with these rare souls. My brother Given had posted something on Facebook that if you can just try and talk to anyone about Jesus, and if they continue for more than 2 minutes, you've found a rare soul. And I instantly knew what he was talking about, because there's been many people that they claim the I'm doing the right thing, and but you tell me about Jesus. What do you know about Jesus? I'm glad that I'm with a group of people here that know a lot about Jesus. He allowed me to leave a good testimony at my first job here, Protein Solutions. And I did it the right way. I did it the way that when I show up there on that day, he's going to say, well done. And I didn't. I did it. He enabled me to do it, but I did it. I want to give him thanks for the times when my wife was down and he raised her up with me. She's at home with the little one, sick right now, but she's been a fantastic helpmeet for me. And I really wouldn't be able to. I'm thankful that I have her. That's what I'm trying to say. I'm continuing to leave a good testimony at my job that I have now. My final thing that I want to say is that they approved me for a raise, and the raise that I got is supposedly more than most people get after working there for 5 or 6 years. But the guy told me, he said, you earned it. So it came just in time because of the insurance. We had to have money for insurance and everything, and I've learned to just trust him just a day at a time. Don't worry about don't worry about what next week is going to be like or what next month is going to be like. And because it's never going to look right. It's never going to look. But if you just step out in faith and you just really believe he's going to take care of me. He's really going to take care of me. That there's nothing really that's going to happen that's going to be outside of his control. He's on the right hand. He's ordering all of our circumstances right now. So I'm really thankful. I'm really thankful that I got the opportunity to get up here and speak. And I just want to be able to come when I come up here, give what I'm gonna say in a concise manner and not trip over my words and stuff. I'm also very thankful that he's allowed me to see different aspects of me that need improvement and need growth and stuff, and that I've been able to ask him to improve these areas of my life, and he's faithful. All I know is that if he's a rewarder. So if there's anything that you're deficient in, you just ask him, and he gives liberally. So I'm really thankful. Thank you, brethren.